Hello everyone. I thought I'd let you see how I'm doing on my corner to corner cross stitch pattern that I've chosen to do. I'm not giving away the pattern, I'm just showing you how I'm doing this. I find C2C very easy to do, turning thing from a cross stitch into a C2C. And all it is just counting the squares. And it looks like I got a big old hole there, but they're just not spaced out there. So that's 1, 2. I am using a 2mm hook and a size 5 crochet thread. I love the look of thinner threads or yarn. So I'm in the white section right now, and I will show you what the cat eyes and stuff look like in just a minute. I gotta go all the way back down here. When I get to the end, I will show you what it looks like. I am right now currently working with 5 strands. I have a turquoise, 2 whites, a pink, and another white. Yes, my threads get tangled, and I do stop every now and then to untangle them. So it's 54 degrees here. It says it's going to be sunny today, which I think that's wonderful. 54 degrees is still cold to me. I did this 60 rows by 60 rows. It looks a little different that a cross stitch and a C2C. So the picture is going to be a little different than what the C2C looks like. You know, because you're looking at it at a slant instead of in rows. So I'm down here on the end, and this is a good time to show you how, when you finish your row, what you do with it. You make a slip stitch into your chain 3 space there. Turn and do a single crochet up the side. 1, 2, 3, and I always start it just like I would any other, but I only put 2 chains. Make a single crochet in the chain 3, and I do a chain 2. Alright, so I'm going to show you what it looks like. Stretch it out. Let's make sure we get the right side. So here's what it looks like so far. Here is one ear. Here is the other ear. Here is one eye. And there's the other eye. And I will show you what it looks like on here. So as you can see, I got this ear right here, and it, like I said, they don't look alike because this is at an angle, and these are straight across, so it's going to be slanted a little bit. But yeah, there's one ear right here. Here's the other ear. Right here. Here's this eye right here. Yes, right now they are colored in this teal looking color, turquoise. There's the other eye. And I will be starting on the nose. Not this one, but this next row. I'll be doing the nose. And then I will be adding the other color, which would be... I'm not sure if I want to do a black nose or a pink nose. I ain't decided yet. But I think it's going to be fun. So now that I'm down here in this corner, and I'm working my way up now because I've done finished, count them over. That's 2, 4, 6, 8. I'm on row 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. I'm going to be doing row 10. So that means 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So I'm on this one right here. I mean, not that one, I'm sorry. I'm over here. This is number 10 that I'm doing. So number 10, I'm going to go straight up. And it looks like maybe this is when I put the nose in. So I will count these squares going up. And do that many in white, and then start my nose. So let me count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Well, it's not this one. It's the next one. So I'm going back up now. So all I'm going to do is follow the pattern. Follow all the way up till the eye up here. So I'm going to turn sideways, do my chain 3. Well, I did a single crochet there, so I'm going to do a chain 2. And then I'm going to put 3 double crochets. And go right back up. Every row messes your yarn up. I think about every 20 rows I straighten my yarn up, and I apologize for that. This is all the white that I have left, so I'm hoping I can get to the end without having to buy any more. What am I making with it? I have not decided yet. If you've not tried C2C, I think you should give it a try. I did not find it hard at all to learn it. And I'm not sure who actually started it, where I tried it. I'm not for sure who. I believe it was probably in GrapGans that I tried it. So when I get up here by the eye, I will do my count and see how many I have to have to go across the eye. I haven't quite decided yet what how I'm going to put that extra a yellowish green for the eyes. I thought about doing the white and then put some chalk crayon or color it in with something, but I figured no, that's too much. Let's just continue this. I know I'm in the white and it's probably hard to see, but I can't wait to finish this. I got a top in mind I want to do, but I will have to get more white unless I decide to do it, because Hobby Lobby is there's only like 7 colors now of this thread, and I've got some of the old, but there's not enough to do a project with. Now, even though there's special stitches on cross stitching, I was not real sure how I can do those half stitches for and manage to keep a C-to-C pattern. So I elected to put a solid granny stitch, or granny, yeah, granny. 3. So here we go. Getting close. It doesn't take long to do these either. Like I said, I find them very relaxing, because if you do your count right, your pattern should turn out right. And I know I crochet fast, or well, I guess the speed on the camera is not keeping up, but hoping to have just this part done by tomorrow, which is Finish Object Friday. So I don't have, I don't want to say I got a bunch to do, because once I get past the eye, the rest of it is just white back and forth. So unless I run out of white, that's only going to be the trouble. the eye. I want to take a look here. Sometimes that happens because I'm trying to hurry up and get done. And it falls off the hook. I guess that's a way to slow me down. There you go. One, two, three. Okay, I'm going to take a look on my eye. This is going to be the one, two. It's going to be the third one, fourth one. So there's one, two, three. So it's going to be four over. One, two, three. So four is one, two, three, four, five, six squares. Okay. And it's also going to be a drop down one. So if you're looking at it, it's going across. So we're going to have one on this, two, three, four, five. That means I have to use this one. So I will slip stitch into that. Pull this, not tight, just pull it. And I usually give it the length of my stitch there. So it's this long and I put it out there. And then I pull through and do my chain three. One, two, three. So it says I gotta have six now. So here's two, three, and four. Slip stitch. Two, three, and four. So that's one, two. That's three. That's fine. And our last one. Three, four. Okay, here we're gonna go back to our white now. Lay that up there. Give this a little pull. And pull through. Give this a little pull. So as you can see, the pattern goes this way. Push that out of that. So the pattern goes this way. So across here is one, two, three, four. So I have my one, two, three, and there's four. So the across the top of the eye is done now. Across the top of the eye right there, those four, is these four right here. And it leans at a four. One, two, three, four. And then we have this going down this way. It'll be three. And then one, two. It'll be one more. So, that's all we do. So now I need to count between this, the eye, and the top of the ear. So we're on number four. One, two, three, four. So it's 1, 2 of the white and 1, 2, 3 pink. So 2 and 3. So we're going to do 2. I don't need that anymore. So we're going to do 2, 1. Here's the pink, which now we're going to do 2, 3 pinks. So you lay this on the inside. Drop your white that you're using. Pick up your pink. Pull through. And chain 3. 1, 2, 3. You've locked it in there. It's 2, 3. It said 3 pinks. So that's 1. That's 2. And that's 3. So when we connect in the top of this, we're going to go right back to our white. We're going to lay the pink down, give it a little tug. Make sure it's the width of your stitch. And pull through. Chain your 3. And start the rest. Does anybody else do that? You're doing a double crochet and you just do a chain on top of it. Like you finish that stitch. Excuse me. I probably should have put something a different color underneath this. I didn't even think about it. It's my first one. And once again, we're down here at the end. I'll show you again how I do mine. I don't know if it's the correct way. It's just the way I do it. You know, makes sense in my head. So we're going to do this last one. 1, 2, 3. 3 double crochets. 1, 2. 3. So we're going to slip stitch into the top of that chain 3. Turn your work, chain 1, turn your work, and do a single crochet in each stitch, those four stitches. So there's one, two, three, and four. And I chain two, and I start my process over again. There's one, two, and three for a total of four. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed watching this corner to corner pattern, and I will give you updates later on. So yeah, I'm in love with it. All right, thank you so much for watching. See you on the next one. Bye.